I recall that an old lady who happens to be the mother of a friend of mine would praise one of her sons lavishly. She would always be happy whenever he visited or conversed with her, even though the rest of her sons and daughters were also kind to her. Her heart was attached to this one son in particular. I would wonder about this. So one day I asked my friend, why? He replied, the problem is that my brothers do not comprehend my mother's nature. They become too cumbersome for her to bear whenever they sit with her. I asked jokingly, so your highness was the only one able to discover her nature? He laughed and said, yes. Allow me to tell you the secret. My mother is like any other aged woman who loves to talk about womanly issues, such as who got married or divorced, how many sons so and so has, which of them is eldest, what is the name of her first child, and so on. I consider all these frivolous, but she loves chatting about it. She feels that the information she shares with me is priceless, as it cannot be found in any book, audio, or website. She feels that she is relating unique information to me and is delighted to do so. Whenever I sit with her, I instigate such conversations and she becomes elated and continues to speak ceaselessly. My brothers talk about issues that do not interest her. So she feels bored in their company and longs to be in mine. That is all there is to it. Yes, if you realize the nature of the one you are conversing with, what he likes or dislikes, you will be able to capture his heart. So what's the moral of the story? The moral is, use the right flavor. If someone knows that his father prefers silence to excessive talk, then let him deal with his father accordingly in order to gain his love. Similarly, if a wife knows that her husband loves jokes, then let her joke with him. If she discovers the opposite, then she should avoid joking with him. The same can be said about a man dealing with his colleagues, neighbors, and brothers. Do not think for a moment that people are all of same nature, for they differ and come in varieties. That's for today. See you in the next story. Bye.